And as I said, sanctions have always been part of the benefit system. It's nothing new that, that we've introduced.
You have introduced punitive sanctions, though. And you have given absolutely no evidence so far this morning that that is effective in getting people into work. What we've had evidence of is that because of sanctions, people simply no longer go into Job Centre Plus. And as far as we are aware, they've completely fallen off the system. If so much detailed, personalised care is being undertaken by the decision makers, why are so many people being sanctioned and being punitively sanctioned?
Well, hang on.
Why is the system not working?
No, hang on a sec. I have to say that isn't correct.
What's that number of people?
3,000, that would be a month there. That would be
3,000 people a month. Yeah. Who you admit are the most vulnerable, who are going to be sanctioned despite a system which, according to you, Minister, is both personalised, sensitive, extremely detailed, mm-hmm. and its aim is to support these people into work. So one is left with either one or two things. Either the system itself is basically flawed and you haven't noticed how flawed it is, or that what you are asking the decision makers to do, they are failing to do. But the bottom line is that sanctions aren't working.
No. So when we say, as I said, 0.6% of people, and actually the number of people being sanctioned is falling, the number of people who've been sanctioned for ESA is lower in 2014 than it was in 2010-11. So obviously the extra support we're doing is helping. And those people who have been sanctioned who would be vulnerable, again, would be supported with hardship payments. So at every layer there, we are supporting the most vulnerable. And as I said, here is the document for good cause to check, and hear from, you know, home visits. Home visits has been nearly 130,000 home visits for people who are vulnerable, from people who could have agoraphobia, alcohol abuse, mental illness, depression, schizophrenia, stress, nervous shock, eating disorders, depressive reaction. All of these people would get home visits if. And then they might not be sanctioned.
They might be. And therefore, my question is this. Again, if the system is so perfect, if there is this detailed acknowledgement of the individual claimant's illness, mental, physical, why is it necessary to sanction them?
I would imagine that no system is perfect. I